नमस्कार। हाय, आई शेफ कुलदीप सिंह गौर, वर्किंग एसोसिएशन प्रोफेसर। टुडे प्रेजेंटिंग अ वीडियो ऑन द फिश। आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट द फिश कुकरी। इन द फिश कुकरी आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट द टाइप्स ऑफ फिश, क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ फिश, वेरियस कट्स ऑफ फिश, दैट इज स्टोरिंग कंडीशन ऑफ द फिश, हाउ टू कट द फिश, हाउ टू चूज द फिश, वट आर द पॉइंट्स वी सपोज टू कीप इन माइंड वाइल we are choosing the fish, how we check the quality of the fish, the freshness, and on and so many things I will discuss in today's module. After this module, the students will be able to answer the following questions like classification of fish, like types of fish, famous fish preparations, cuts of fish, use of fish cuts, selection of fish, and the about the quality of the fish. So these are the major points which we will cover in the video or in our today's module. So first of all, about the classification, fish can be classified in the two parts, like white fish, oily fish, and the shellfish. If we talk about the white fish, again in the lean fish or the white fish, according to the types of fish, the classification is lean fish and oblique white fish. Another is oily fish. Which fish are like the example of oily fish are salmon, mackerel, trout, sardines, anchovy. These are the types of the oily fish. Another kind of fish is the spatha, according to the shape. Like how as per the shape, the round fish or the flat fish. Round fish, kingfish, example of round fish are kingfish, haddock, sole. Example of flat fish are pomfret, lemon sole, and turbot. Plaice, the some of the examples of the flat fish. Another classification can be according to habit, like ocean fish and the river or lake fish. Another kinds of fish are shellfish. Shellfish also divided in two parts. First is molluscus, and another is crustaceans. What is molluscus? Examples of molluscus are clams, mussels, scallops, and oysters. If I talk about the crustaceans, example of crustaceans are crayfish, lobster, prawns, shrimps, crabs, and turtles. The example of crustaceans. So this is the common classification of the fish. Now I will discuss about the or I will discuss the various difference of the flat fish and the round fish. What is flat fish and what is typically round fish? Flat fish, the fish are flat in the shape. Round fish are the fish are round in the shape. This is the major and the basic difference between the flat fish and the round fish. Another difference is both the eyes are one side in the flat fish. In the flat fish, both the eyes are on the one side. But if I talk about the round fish, the eyes on the either side, the fish means both sides they are heavy on the either side of the fish. If I talk about the flat fish, these fish swim flat to the surface. Peacefully, fish swim flat to the surface of the water with the belly elegant, parallel to the water plate. If we talk about the round fish, these fish swim in a horizontal fashion. These fish swim in a horizontal fashion. Another kind of fish is flat fish. Talk about the flat fish are belly side of the fish is white in color. The belly side of the fish is white in color. Round fish, both the sides of the fish are same in color. And the belly side is the white in the color, but round fish, both the sides are same in color. If I talk about the examples, examples are flies, turbot, plunder, skate, halibut, sole. You see, are the examples of the flatfish. Examples of the flatfish. If you talk about the round fish, examples of the round fish are salmon, trout, snappers, etc. We talk about the yield flatfish. Having the yield of flatfish, it yields 4 fillet. Make around 4 fillet. We talk about the round fish, we are having only 2 fillet only. Flatfish yield are having 4 fillet, and the round fish are having only 2 fillet. So these are the basic difference between flat fish and the round fish. How we choose or how we select the quality of the good fish? What are the basic quality of the good fish? How we select or how we will check that fish is good quality or having the bad quality, good or bad? So these are some of the criteria we supposed to keep in mind, and we check on the behalf of these criteria. So first of all is, fish should look and smell fresh. The look and smell of the fish should looks like freshness, not stingy, not bad. The scales should be intact, firmly adhering and shiny. The scales should be intact, firmly adhering and shiny. Talk about the eye. The eye should be full and bulging, but not sunken. Eye should be full and bulging, but not should be sunken. Talk about the gills. The gills of the fish should be brighter in red color. Gills of the fish should be bright red in the color. When poked or pressed with fingers, the flesh should feel firm and resilient. Restricting. When poked, it come back to its original shape. When we poke, it should be come back very fast. It should not be sticking like this. It should come as you press, it should come on top, come like this. Talk about the guts. Organs, especially related to the digestive system, belly should not be torn. Sagging or swollen. When the fish is open, the guts should be smooth and clean. These should not sagging or swollen. These should be smooth and clean. Taste a cut piece of the fish. Press down with a finger to taste cut piece of the fish. Taste cut pieces of the fish. Press down with a finger and if impression is left, then the fish is still. If the impression is left, then the fish is still. Raw flesh should not come away from the bones, as it is the sign of fish detrition. So these are the some of the quality aspects of purchasing the fish. What are these? Look, smell fresh. Fiscal should be intact and farming. Eye should be full and building but not shrunken. The gills of the fish should be bright red color. When poked or pressed with fingers, the flesh should feel firm and resilient. Guts belly should not be torn. To taste a cut piece of the flesh, fish, press down with the finger. If the impression of the left dam, then the fish is still. So these are the some of the quality aspects of the selecting the fish. How to select shellfish? What are the things we supposed to check when we selecting the shellfish? First thing, they should be bought in season as far as possible. They supposed to be bought in the season only. They should be medium size and good weight, not very big, not very small. It is the best to buy them alive. If you are purchasing the shellfish, you must or you suppose to buy or purchase alive. Particularly oyster, crabs and lobster, especially oyster, crabs and lobster supposed to be purchase alive only. Not diet. Whenever you are purchasing, you purchase alive only. If they are dyed, the following proportions should be taken. Some of the proportions you are supposed to take if these shellfish you purchased are dyed. The claws of crabs should be springly and not hanging down. The claws of crabs should be springy and not hanging down. Other things, the eye should be bright. The eye of the shellfish should be bright. The tails of lobster should spring back. The tails of the lobster should spring back when strengthened out. It should be spring back when strengthened out. Shrimps and prawns must be crispy. Changing shrimps or prawns, they must be crispy in nature. Oyster shells should be tightly closed. Oyster shells should be tightly closed, not open. If they are open, don't pry. They don't have, if the shrimps and prawns don't crispy, are not crispy, then don't buy. If the tails of lobster not spring back, then don't buy. So these are the some of the points we should keep in mind when we are selecting or purchasing the shellfish. Talk about the shellfish. What are the shellfish? Molluscus, oysters, scallops, crustaceans, jointed, lobsters, crabs, shrimps, prawns, crayfish, carabfish, these are the examples. Buying of seafoods, what are the things we are supposed to keep in mind? Sniff. The seafood should be sniffed. It should have a fresh, clean aroma. It should not smell fishy. Have a strong odor like ammonia, which means that the fish is spread to decay. So it should have a fresh and the clean aroma. We talk about the feel. Slick and moist. If the scales are present, they should be firmly attached. Press. About the press quality, it should feel firm and spring back when you release your fingers. If a visible finger imprint remains, then the fish is not fresh. Should be feel firm and spring back when you release your fingers. If a visual finger is imprint remains, then the fish is not fresh. So check of the, this is the criteria or of the checking of the freshness of the fish. Buying seafood, look into the eyes. Looks into the eyes. They should be bulging and crystal clear. As a fish is, the eye lose moisture and the eye sink into the head. Buying of the seafood, what are the things should check? Check the gills. They should be moist and have a good red maroon color with no trace of gray on the brown. This is checking. Fin and tails, they should be firm enough. Next is no belly, no bones. What is no belly, no bones? There should be no sign of belly bones, which occurs when the guts are improperly removed. The flesh should show no tears or breaks. What happens in the stomach? Enzymes, beings to eat into the flesh, causing it to come away from the bones. This happens if the guts are not removed properly. When can it happens? No belly. What is the meaning of no belly, no bones? There should be no sign of belly bones, which occurs when the guts are improperly removed. The flesh should show no tears on break. What happens if the stomach enzymes begin to eat into the flesh, causing it to come away from the bones? This happens if the guts are not removed properly. What about live fish shopping? Live fish shopping means sign of movement. Lobster, crabs must move. If you're purchasing alive, so then lobster, crabs must move. Arms and muscles must close. Using arms and muscles, they must be close. Next is about the cleaning of the fish. How we clean? What are the basic principles of cleaning? So first, primary cleaning. What are the primary cleaning of the fish? Clean the fish well. Cut off the fins. Clean the fish well and cut off the fins. Scrape off the scales. Scrape off the scales. Scrape off the scales. Remove the fins and the gills. Make a slit in the belly. Remove all the internal organs. This is also known as gutting of the fish. Wash them in running water to remove all the blood and any physical impurities. I talk about the cuts of fish. These are some of the cuts. I'm not showing over here the shape, exact shape of the cuts. I'm explaining the description of the particular cuts. First of all is the darne. What is darne? Darne is take a slice of round fish cut into the cut on the bone. Darne is the steak or the slice of a round fish cut on the bones. It's called the darne. Next is troncon. What is troncon? A steak or slice of a flat fish. Steak or the slice of a flat fish cut on the bones. The bones is the troncon. Popite. Thin slice of fish fillet with usually stubbed and rolled like a cylinder. This is a thin slice of fish fillet which is usually stubbed with something and rolled into a cylinder, rolled like a cylindrical shape, called the popite. Next is fillet. What is actually fillet? Usually boneless cuts of fish from one entire side of the fish. What is the boneless cut of fish from one entire side of the fish? This is the fillet. Goujons. What is exactly goujons? Goujons are the fillet of fish cut into the strips of 6 cm to 1 cm into 1 cm. This is the fillet of fish cut into the strips of 1 cm, 1 cm, 6 cm, 1 cm, 1 cm. About the size on a finger. This is called the goujons. Next is goujonets. What is goujonets? Goujonets are thinner and a smaller version of the fish finger. Cocktail size fish finger are the end of goujonets. Another is cornet. What is cornet? Thin slice of a fish fillet. And cornet is the thin slice of the fish fillet. Usually triangular in shape, which is rolled to form a cone. This is called the cornet. Next is ply. Ply fillet, which is flattened and folded into two, called the ply. Next is supreme. A large fillet of fish cut on the slant. Large fillet of fish cut on this slant from a large round or a flat fish. It's called the supreme. Next is medallions. Medallions is a boneless round shaped steak or slice of fish fillet, usually cut from a large fillet of the fish. Next stage, delights. What is delights? Menu terms denoting the folded fillet called the delights. So these are the some of the famous cuts of the fish with online description. Purpose of online description is this: we should know what is the shape or what is the cutting size or cutting pattern of these particular cuts of the fish. Again, I am repeating the various cuts of fish are the dorne, pancon, fillet, supreme, delice, papites, flights, gujons, pau, and crevette. If I talk about the storing of the fish, what are the correct storing of the temperature? Or what temperature we supposed to store the fish? Or fresh fish should be stored for a short time. Fresh fish should be stored for a short time. As possible, after purchase, fish that has been freshly caught in the best of the cooking. Best for cooking. Ideal temperature for storing of fish. Ideal temperature for storing of fresh fish is 0 degree centigrade. Ideal temperature for fish walk-in refrigerator is minus 2 degree centigrade to 0 degree centigrade. Whole fish will keep fresh for a longer time if it is gutted, removing the intestine. As enzyme present in the stomach accelerate because fish should be stored tightly wrapped in a clean film and covered with ice. Cut of fish or the cut fish should never come in contact directly with ice. Cut fish should never come in contact directly with ice as it discolors the flesh and drawn out the juice. So if you are keeping in the ice, always cover the fish with the help of the clean film or the plastic wraps. I talk about the storage. Ideally should be fresh. When storing the fish, it should be fresh. Otherwise, in a refrigerator, rinse in cold water. Otherwise, store in the refrigerator, rinse in cold water, in crushed ice. Container should be perforated. Container to collect metallic ice. So these are the some storing tips of the fish. More tips for storage are: fish fillet should be in a plastic bag in ice. Ice should not come in contact with the fish or will lose its flavor as well as its texture. So always keep in the plastic bag. The flavor will be affected if it will comes in the contact of the ice. Some more tips about the fish. Never allow fresh water to come in contact with the live shellfish. Never ever allow the fresh water to come in the contact with the live shellfish. Means in the live shellfish, you are using a live shellfish, the shellfish container, the water should be salty, the sea water only, not the fresh water or the well water. Palms, mussels, oysters, never keep in ice. Store them in the mesh bag only. Never keep on ice. Palms and oysters are served. Mussels are not served, only where only beards are removed. Talk about the marinades. But we use the ingredients in the marination. What are the role of the particular ingredients in the marination? First of all, I am talking about the name of the ingredients which we use in the marinades. What are these ingredients? Salt, pepper, lime juice, spices, herbs, olive oil, sometime orange oil, mustard. So these are the common ingredients which are used in the marination. First, few ingredients are commonly each marination they are used. They will use are salt, pepper, lime juice, herbs, and olive oil. These are the ingredients which are used in all the kind of fish marination. Extra things which are added in the fish marination are like mustard, like orange juice, like spices, like herbs. So these are additional ingredients which are used in the marinades. How long? At least for 30 minutes. Or at least it's supposed to be used usually for 1 to 2 hours. Minimum 30 minutes supposed to be used. And use more than 30 minutes, but minimum is required is at least 30 minutes is supposed to marinate the fish. If you talk about the various cooking methods which are used in the fish are following. Various kinds of cooking methods which are used in the fish marination are grilling, shortening, cold and hot poaching, olive oil poaching, steaming, fat boosters, and the smoking. These are the various cooking methods which are used in the cooking of the fish. What are these methods? Grilling, sauteing, cold and hot poaching, olive oil poaching, steaming, and the stoming and steaming are the common methods which are used in the fish in the marination of the fish. If you talk about the cooking of the shellfish, lean, low fat, moist heat, low temperature, this should be cut at lean, low fat, moist heat, low temperature, dry heat and high heat which makes them rubbery and tough. This is the kind of temperature or the moderate temperature which is used in the preparation of the fish or in the cooking of the fish. So we will discuss about some of the main course preparations and some of the preparations which are made out of the fish also. Before this, I will discuss some of the things about the cod bouillon. What is exactly cod bouillon? Bouillons to preserve and enhance the delicate flavor of fish. The liquid cod bouillon to present and enhance the delicate flavor of fish. the liquid in which they are posed in the prepared with care. The poaching liquor is called poured bullion. Poured bullions. There are different types of poured bullions are found in the kitchen. What are the various kinds of poured bullions? White poured bullion. What is exactly white poured bullion? It's poured bullion with the milk. Ordinary poured bullion with lemon and vinegar. Next is white wine poured bullion. White wine poured bullion. And next is the wine should be chosen from its fruity flavor to improve a special delicate flavor. Wine should be chosen for its fruity flavor to improve a special delicate flavor. The amount of wine can be increased, the amount of water is reduced by the same quantity. Red wine is used especially if the poured bullion is used to make an aspic jelly, which will then have a pale pink color. Poured bullion with white wine are used for cooking shellfish and fish of all types. Shellfish or fish of the types. Poured bullion with red wine is used for cooking lean white flashing fish such as bass are served hot. Talk about the recipe of the poured bullion. The usual recipe: water 1 liter, salt or sea salt 10 grams, wine around 75 grams, carrots around 60 grams, bay leaf 2 number, peppercorn 6 number, thyme 1 space, parsley stalks 3 number, and the fish bones. This is the common recipe of the poured bullion. If I talk about the accompaniments and all with the fish, some of our grilled fish serve with the fried or the sauteed potato. If I talk about the vegetables, which kind of vegetables are served? Green salad, whole, slow carrot, onion and chowder. Next is Indian sauce, tartar sauce, slice of lemon, parsley, brown butter, and pepper sauce. It is. What are the vegetables you just served with this patients are green salads, poured coleslaw, carrot, onion and cauliflower. Another kinds of fish preparations are boiled or steamed preparation. What you need with this? Boiled in jacket smashed green salad, beans, usually served vegetables are green side beans, salad onions, tomatoes, cucumbers, cauliflowers. Talk about their complements are hollandaise sauce. Egg fennel, sauce parsley, etc. are the quite a common accompaniments which are served in the boiled, steamed fish. Next kind of preparation method of the fish is baking method. For baking, baked, boiled or sauteed potato, green salad, carrots, beans, tomato, spinach, celery, onions and cauliflower are the vegetables which are served with the baked fish. Talking about the complements, hollandaise sauce, mustards, sauce, mustard sauce, tartar sauce, pepper sauce and the parsley butter. These are the major source and all of the selection of the fish. Now I will discuss about the some of the main course preparations of the fish, the starter preparations of the fish. The main course, first is, I'm discussing the deep fried fish. What are the correct examples of deep fried fish are? Fish and chips. A simple preparation made with firm texture, finished such as cod and sea bass, which are traditionally dependent, traditionally dipped a batter of flour. Egg, salt, baking powder, milk. Then deep fry. It's the method of making the fish and chips. These are served with long lengthwise potato fingers or chips of the French fry. Lemon wedge and red parsley. Traditionally, this British snacks is served in cones of newspapers sprinkled with vinegar. Means this is United Kingdom or the British snacks or the British street snacks. In India, fish and chips are commonly denotes fillet of fish which are coated with breadcrumb and deep fried. Yeah, fillet of fish which is deep fried, which is dipped in the batter and the deep fried, called the fish and chips. Next is fish orle. What is fish orle? Fish fillet is marinated in lemon juice, oil, chopped parsley and salt. A batter is made with flour. A stiffly beaten egg. White, beer and seasoning. This fish is dipped in the batter, deep fried, served with fried parsley and tomato sauce or the tomato nature. Next is fish culvert. How we make the fish culvert? Fillet of fish coated with breadcrumbs and deep fried, served with slice of lemon and maitre d', which is butter. Next stage, fritto misto. An Italian seafood and fish preparations. Which is usually served as an appetizer. And consists of a small bite size piece of the fish. Squid, oyster, and other seafoods which is cumbered. Deep fried, usually served with lemon parsley and roasted bell pepper sauce. Next is Siciliani. What is exactly Siciliani? Same as fish culvert, but served with brown butter, capers, and chopped anchovies and sieved hard boiled egg. Next famous preparations which are made of the fish are the shellified. What is shellified? Sole Meunier. The fish is marinated and pitted with flour and sole fried. Served with slice of lemon and sprinkle with lemon juice, hot brown butter, and chopped parsley at the last moment. Next is Bella Muniera, very simple or Muniere, but garnished with blanched tomatoes, sliced sauteed mushrooms, and few grains of caviar. Next is Green Blois. Vino Blois. Fish Meunier garnished with segments of lemon and peppers. Next is poached method. Poached fish preparations are red snapper, dugler, sole vermicelli, big pea, pinces. Fish is poached in white wine and fish fumet. The cooking liquid is strained and reduced to a sauce like consistency with a sauteed chopped garlic, dices of onion, blanched tomato, and the chopped parsley. At the last moment, cream is added to the sauce, and this sauce is poured over the roast fish. Another preparation is sole vermicelli. This is poached in fumé and served with blanched and peeled with grapes, and fish velouté is made with the poaching liqueur. Next is baked tea princess. Poached fillet of baked tea served with fish velouté made with the poaching liquid and white wine. It is garnished with slice of sauteed mushrooms and blanched asparagus tips. These are some of the famous preparations which are made out of the fish. If I talk about the baked fish preparations are salmon, trilobites. Salmon fillet arranged over a layer of the cooked rice, chopped hard boiled, egg and pretzels enclosed or covered with brioche dough, baked and served like a pie. Next preparation is sole nicoise. What is sole nicoise? Marinated fillet of sole placed on a bed of tomato tancasse and baked in a hot oven. Served with a garnish of black olives, anchovy fillet, and slice of lemon. Another is the fish stew. What is fish stew exactly? Bolognese. It is the most famous of all Mediterranean fish soups, which originated in the Marseille region of the South France. It is a rich and colorful mixture of fish and the shellfish, which is flavored with tomato, saffron, rinds of orange, and usually garnished with chopped parsley. Traditionally, bouillon base is always made with the rockfish, red mullet, monkfish, squid, and small crabs. So these are some of the famous preparations which are made of the fish. Another are lobster thermidor, prawn newbox, etc. If you talk about some of the species of the salmon, are the Pacific salmons, Atlantic salmons, snook salmons, chum salmons, chow salmon, etc. Talk about the species of the tuna are ahi, big eye, yellowfin, bonito, bluefin, etc. We talk about the classical preparations of the seafoods are cavrecce peore, sausage, rollomops. So these are some of the preparations for some of the various species of the fish. So now in the conclusion, we have discussed about the various species of the fish, storing conditions of the fish, selection and choosing of the fish, classification of fish, and so many things we have learned in our today's lecture, today's video. Now I will discuss some of multiple choice questions with you guys. So now start to solve these questions. What form of fish has the shortest shellfish life? Which form of fish have the shortest shellfish life? Whole fish are the form of fish which have the shortest shelf life. Cuts of fish are having the longer shelf life, but whole fish having the lesser shelf life. Which of these types of mollusk is available year round? Clam, oyster, mussels. Correct answer is the scallop. What category of fish includes flounder and habit food? Flatfish having this category. Next is, what is the most common cut of fish offered in the restaurants? Most common or most famous cuts of fish which is served or which is offered in the restaurant is the fillet. Or true or false? Shellfish have no bones. Is true or false? What is the internal temperature? What internal temperature is minimum required temperature for baking the fish? The 145 degree Fahrenheit. Which of these characteristics of a side dish is most important when served with the seafood? The texture. Wrapping fish or shellfish in parchment paper, with vegetable herbs, sauce or butter, this type of steaming called, what is called broiling, sauteing, and popularly is the type of steaming. Leftover piece from the large fish are called as cubes. To keep the fish from sticking when sauteing or pan frying, we use flour oblique breading so that the fish will not stick to the bottom. Next question. Which of the following cooking techniques works better for lean fish? For lean fish, which cooking technique is work much more better? It's the sauteing. Sauteing, sauteing. Next is, what category of fish has backbone on the upper edge of its body? What category of fish had backbones on the upper edge of its body? Round fish, fatty fish, flat fish, boneless fish. Which fish? Round fish are having the backbone on the upper edge of its body. Next is, whole fish are not suited for boiling. Is this true or false? This is true. So these are some of the multiple choice questions. After all these question solving, I'm closing my today's lecture over here only. Next video, next time, next class, we will come again with the next topic. Thank you very much for giving your precious time. I'm stopping my video over here only. Thank you very much for listening. Thanks.